the book of Psalms, chapter 27. If you have your Bibles, the book of Psalms, chapter 27. And this one is entitled David's Love to God's Service. Amen. The book of Psalms, chapter 27. I'll be reading verses 1 through 6. 27, 1 through 6.
Amen.
We're all there, say amen.
Amen.
All right, it starts off by saying, the Lord is my light and my salvation.
Yes.
Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life.
Yes.
Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell.
Yeah.
Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear.
That's right.
The war shall rise against me,
and
this will I be confident.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I have, I desire of the Lord,
yes.
That will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple.
Yes.
For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion.
Yes.
In the secret of his tabernacle,
yes.
Shall he hide me, and shall set me upon a rock.
Yeah.
Verse 6, and now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer his tabernacle sacrifice of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord.
Yes.
I read the book of Psalms, chapter 27, verses 1 through 6. Let these words be a blessing to the reader, hearer, and doer of his holy words. Can we all say amen?
Amen.
Now, brothers and sisters, I'd like to pray for those who are sick. I'd like to pray for those families that want to grieve this morning. Amen. I see our sister Helen's not here this morning. I'd like to say a prayer for her and her family. Amen. The Anthony family. Amen.
Amen.
We lost a sister last month. So I believe her name is Deborah Anthony. Amen. I'd like to say a prayer for her family.
Amen.
So I have to see our sister Reese here this morning.
Amen.
Good to see you. My good friend Michael Simon here this morning.
Praise God.
See Crystal and her family here this morning.
Amen.
Even my brother with me. Amen.
Amen.
God is good. Amen. See brother here. Amen. Amen.
Praise God. Brother Wayne in here.
Brother Wayne. Where's Brother Wayne? There he is.
Hiding behind him.
Yeah, Brother Wayne. Amen. See my brother here, Brother Wayne. Amen.
Yeah.
He said to me this morning, and I heard what he went on last week. What he said about me. Words are good around, don't you, brother? Yes, I heard y'all had a good time.
Yeah.
morning wake up this morning, Father, someone home to glory, Father. Father, like I said, a prayer for the guests this time, Father, that you want to learn, Father. Father, like I said, a prayer for the Carter family that they're going through in their life. Father, like I said, a prayer for our sister, Sister Helen, and others. Like I said, a prayer for her family who lost her sister last month. Like I said, a prayer for her. Let her know that our church is with her. The Lord said, I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you in this time of need. Heavenly Father, it's good to see our brother Wayne here this morning, Father.
Hallelujah, thank you.
We've been praying for him, Father.
Amen.
We ask that you touch his heart, Father. Yes, he is here, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Before we bring him up, we'll sing this simple song. What do we sing here?
Let the church say amen.
Let the church say amen.
Oh,
us alive.
Emmanuel.
Sometimes we don't know God until we go through something. Y'all didn't hear what I said.
Say that again.
We don't know God until we go through a trial and tribulation.
That's right.
While everything is good, we got money in our pockets, we're rolling and riding fives, leaning to the side with the gangster man. We don't know that. Hello, somebody. We just keep it at 100.
Yeah.
Amen. As soon as the walls start caving in, amen, then we know God. Amen.
Amen.
Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Am I right or wrong? God never changes. We change. Amen. Don't be one of those that know God until trouble come. Amen. Brother Dunny, that's why we used to sing that song called Trouble in My Way.
Trouble in my way.
Amen. ran across a lot of folk. And I went to a lot of the plantation homes. And I had an opportunity to see what our ancestors went through.
Yeah.
Had an opportunity to see the shackles they used to wear. I say used to wear, some of us still wearing them today.
Oh, Lord, help us, Jesus.
Around our mind. Brainwashed. Scary. Don't want to stand up. No backbone. Just useless. Say useless.
Useless.
God can't use anyone that's useless. He has to use someone that's ready to get into the game. Ready to build the kingdom. Amen. Ready to put it on the line. Amen. Ready to speak truth to power. Amen. We don't have many folk like that in Fresno. Amen. Sometimes I feel alone. Amen. Don't see many people out on the front line. God said in the first book of Genesis, he told Adam, he said, I give you dominion to go to work in the garden. Amen. That's what God has instructed me to do. You'll find out on this journey that many people become jealous of you for the skill sets that God has given you. You could be in Sister Evelyn worked at the hospital. She paid her dues, amen. You get the young girls coming out of college, amen. Fresh, amen. Know how to run the computer, winning their sleep, amen. And you see Sister Evelyn, amen. Look at that old woman over there, amen. We fresh out of college, amen. We know what we're doing, amen. And they come in. Just disrespectful, amen. Don't come in and giving her her props and giving her her honor, amen. I don't think they know it all, amen. And then they come to find out, once they get to know Sister Evelyn, they don't know nothing, amen. And it goes for a lot of our jobs, amen. And those are civil rights leaders, there's many folk jealous of me, amen. Not that I boast. God's given me favor to know how to do certain things, amen. People become jealous, envy, strive, and then they want to kill you, amen. They're upset because you have relationships with people, children, kids. Instead of getting with you and learning, they become jealous, amen. Just keep that with you, amen, as we move forward. Brother Devon, you ready? Amen. We won't be before you long. Have you had a good time up to now?
Yeah.
Amen. We had some wonderful singing. Amen. I'm still getting my strength back. Amen. Don't feel 100%. But it's kind of an up and down type of situation with the sickness. But I'm still pressing. Amen. Not letting the sickness become an excuse not to come to church.
Amen.
Not letting it be an excuse not to go and hit on the drums. I know I sound like you throw corn to a chicken, amen. Not making an excuse, amen, to stop doing God's work, amen. Just look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, I love you. Don't that feel good? Sister, she had a big smile on her face. I don't know who told you they loved you, but whoever told you, Lord, they made you smile. Amen.
Great God.
Isn't it good to feel peaceful? Amen. We have so much hell going on in this world. We don't know one thing to the next is going to happen. We have folks walking in the church, shooting folk, killing folk. Amen. Shootings in the schools, amen. Just don't know where death is. We ask favor from God to just be with us. Amen. If you would bow your heads, please. Father God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for another opportunity.
Yes.
Thank you for those who came, God. We ask that you would just bless them, God. Whatever prayers went up today, God, and just honor those prayers, God. Whatever those are going through something this morning, God, we ask that you would give them favor, touch their heart. Give them the wisdom to deal with their situation, God. God, you know the journey that you have me on, God. Sometimes I don't know why you chose me, God. But God, I have a work to be done. Give me the strength, God. Give me the wisdom. Give me the courage. Give me the words to empower your people, God. So they know that they are something. Shortest month of the year, and the country they acknowledge this is Black History Month. I want you to know that Black History is 365 days out of the year. It's 24 hours a day. Every second on the clock, you're Black. Amen. And you have a lot to be proud about. Our ancestors paid a big price for you to be sitting here today. A lot of people died. A lot of people were murdered. A lot of people were lynched for us to be sitting here. So I don't want you to forget those who sacrificed for you. I think sometimes we get complacent and we forget.
Yes.
Things are going good. But we don't know what people went through for you and I to be sitting here today. Amen. You remember the church, I think it was in Alabama, wasn't it? They got blown up. The four little girls. Church, just like this. Four little babies in the church. Klan came out and put some bombs in there and blew up our little babies. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine children being in here? And you get a call and say, well, the church blew up and your children were in it.
Why?
How do you process that? Amen. Can you process that Megan Evers was getting folks to vote in Mississippi. And he went home with his three little girls behind the door. And somebody came up behind him and blew his brains out when he put the key in the door. Fatherless daughters. Amen. He paid a price for us to be here today. And then we have people with the nerve to say, I don't want to vote. I don't want to vote. We're living in some sad times. Some sad times now. We're going to be reading from Matthew. Amen. It's Matthew 53. Came to Fresno.
Yes.
A prophet without honor. Dr. King came to Fresno.
Yes.
Back in 64. And his footprint is here in the city. I was born till 1970.
Yeah.
So I missed it. Pastor, was you here in 64? Was Pastor here in
64? I was a
young blood. Pastor was a young blood. He didn't say cuz, he said blood. Don't say New Light is gang affiliated. He said, I was a young blood. Blood's on this side, cuz on this side. Okay. We all. It was God's blood that was shed on Calvary, amen. So Pastor's on point when he says blood, amen. But Dr. King came to Fresno. And I believe he marched to Radcliffe Stadium. There's a picture I've seen of him in the front of the line. It was, says clergy. There's a lot of churches or pastors with Dr. King at the time. And I asked Brother DeVern if he would read what Dr. King said in 1964. And the reason I want him to read what Dr. King said. Who's a math person in here? From 1964 till today is how many years?
64 till today.
56. King was here 56 years ago, and here we are 56 years later. And I want Devon to read what Dr. King said, if you can get to the microphone or something.
Dr. Harris will speak from Matthew 13:57.
13.
In June 1964, Rev. Martin Luther King Jr. brought the Civil Rights Movement to Fresno. He led a march to Radcliffe Stadium, where he spoke at a rally attended by several thousands of people. This is the bees from Page story about Dr. King times in Fresno. The Rev. Martin Luther King Jr. says the nation must recognize the urgency of the moment. In the fight for the civil rights, if the American dream, quality for all, is to become a reality. Now is the time to make brotherhood a reality. He told an audience of more than 3,000 persons at a Witness of Faith for Freedom rally last night in Windy. Dust swept Radcliffe Stadium. The 35-year-old Baptist minister head to the Southern Christian Leadership Conference and leader of the nonviolent civil rights movement said Negroes across the nation still are hearing cries of wait, you're pushing too fast.
Amen. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Did you hear what Dr. King said?
Yes.
How many years was that?
56
years ago.
56.
Has things gotten better in Fresno? Still got homeless people walking around?
More so.
Got no housing for folks. We adding on to the jail.
Yeah.
Police department getting all the budget.